just had the most amazing run out on cross country that you think you've ever had. Everything went according to plan, but you saw his ride, and you can tell he wasn't having as good of a day as you were. Hi, my name is Emily Worth, and today I'm here to present to you on the challenges of cross country jumping safety. Today I will be covering what cross country is, the difficulties of the sport, rider injury statistics, current safety precautions, and my own personal experience. Cross country. Cross country is part of eventing, which is a traditional English horse sport. It is a jumping phase, and it tests the endurance and the bond of trust between the horse and rider. You have to be able to go out there on course and trust that your horse is going to listen to you to make decisions, but your horse has to also be able to trust that you are going to make smart, safe decisions out there to bring you both back home in one piece. The difficulties. Cross country is difficult for three main things: the jumps themselves, possible weather problems, and the lay of the land. These are the rider injury statistics from a survey done by the USEA, which is the United States Eventing Association, on riders who fell in 2015 and 2016. 94% of those surveyed reported no injury. 3% said only a minor injury, which would be a cut or a scrape or a slight concussion. 3% said a major injury, which would be something like a broken arm or leg or a severe concussion. And of that 3% that had major injuries, 0.14% were very serious and in some cases fatal. Of those serious and fatal injuries, one of the leading causes is rotational falls. A rotational fall is when the horse takes off at a jump and hits the front of the jump with their chest and shoulders, stopping their forward momentum, but the back end keeps going, essentially flipping the horse over themselves. This is an example of a rotational fall. The jumps. The jumps are dangerous for two main reasons: the type of jump it is, and the way the jump has been designed. Type. Jumps are also called questions because you ask your horse to go over them. There are hundreds upon hundreds of different types of jumps. I will be going over some of the most common ones you will find here today. As you advance through the levels, the jumps can get increasingly difficult. Here are some of your most basic types. Here we have a vertical log. Here we have what is called a bank jump, and it's essentially like a big step, and it can be jumped going up or coming down. And here we have what is called a ditch jump. Here are some more examples of just how extreme some of your simplest kinds of jumps can get. Design. The design of the jumps is made to grab your horse's attention and intimidate them into thinking that they can't go over that because it's too scary. Here, as you can see with the spider, the body of the spider is where the horse is supposed to go over the jump, but the legs coming out from the base will draw the horse's attention so that it's not focusing on what's important, so that when the time comes to jump, it's not ready and you could crash into the jump. And as you can see with the rest of these jumps here, a jump designer's imagination holds no bounds. Weather. Weather can be dangerous for various reasons. Cross country is rarely canceled. You will ride rain or shine. If it's thunderstorming or raining so hard you can't see in front of your face, common sense would say you're not going to go run cross country. Ultimately, the decision of cancellation is up to the ground jury, who are the people actually out there on course making sure everything is still safe, and the officials running the event. Rain is the most common weather problem you will encounter, and it creates two main problems, the first being impaired visibility. When the horse and rider are trying to look through the rain, it can make them misjudge where the jump is. They may think it's here at point A when it's actually at point B, and that can cause them to jump at the wrong time, causing them to land on top of the jump or crash into the front of it. The second big problem with rain is mud. Everybody knows when you're walking through mud, you go more slowly, you go carefully, because you could slip and fall. The horses are running full speed through the mud, jumping things that don't fall down. When the mud causes their feet to slip, it could again cause them to crash into the jump, leading to disastrous results. Lead the land. Lead the land is dangerous for two main reasons, one of them being previous tracks. As you can see in this picture here, there's a large brown streak in the background, and there's mud all up the horse's side and neck. That brown streak in the background is where horses have been running over the same patch of ground all day long. The ground has now been torn up, it's loose, it's not secure anymore. So when that horse went through that ground, they slid and they fell, causing the rider to come off. The second reason for land is the way the jumps have been positioned because of the land. As you can see here, this type of jump is a bank jump, as I spoke of earlier, and it's being jumped downhill, but it's also on a very steep downhill slope. When you're going on a downhill jump or walking downhill in general, your shoulders are naturally pulled forward because that's the way the earth goes. And when you combine the forces of the steep hill and the downhill bank, trust me, gravity is not your friend and you will come tumbling over the horse's head. And that's not a good day for anybody. And it just goes to show how much you have to take into attention every single little detail, things you wouldn't even think of, in order to ride the jump safely. Current safety precautions. There are many things that have been done to make cross country safer over the years. One of the first being your vests. I have mine here today, and as you can see, it opens up and has panels on the inside and protects your upper body. This acts as a barrier between you and that solid block of wood you're trying to go over. If you hit that jump, this is going to take the brunt of the impact so that your vital organs remain safe. Also, you must have a helmet that is ASTM or SEI and SEI certified. This is mine, and as you can see, it conforms to your head, and it's pretty hard. If you unfortunately hit the jump with your head, this will protect your brain. It's a pretty important organ. You kind of need that. And you also must have your medical armband or wristband. This has your immediate medical information on it, like your name, your date of birth, allergies you may have, things like that, so that medical service personnel can treat you immediately, knowing what they can and cannot do. Emergency medical services are on site. You will always see an ambulance on the cross-country course. That way, in case something does happen, you can get medical treatment right away. This is something new. It's come out in the past couple of years. It's called an air vest. And here is before inflation, and here is after inflation. It has a little CO2 cartridge in the front that connects on a pin to a strap in the saddle. And when you come out of the tack, poof, you inflate like the Michelin Man. And it just creates that extra bubble of protection between you and that jump. Now, this, as you can see, is a thin shell, so it must be worn over your traditional vest, or nowadays they create something called a hybrid, which is a combination between the two, but you cannot just wear the shell of the air vest. This is an example of the medical armband, and as you can see, it has a little white card in the front that actually comes out and opens up, and it has everything on there. Your name, your date of birth, when you were previous accidents, allergies you have, medications you're currently on, how you were treated, everything, so that those medical care providers can know everything right away and they can know how they're allowed to treat you. These are called studs. They are actually a safety device for your horse. And as you can see, these are little metal devices that go into the horse's shoe, and they allow your horse to get that extra little dig into the ground to give them that extra traction. Kind of like soccer cleats for athletes. My experiences. I have had a lot of cross-country experiences, some of them good, some of them bad. I have not been able to breathe for a minute because I hit the jump and had the breath knocked out of me. I have seen friends not be able to ride for months because they broke their wrist or they got a concussion and they couldn't tell me their name. And they couldn't tell me why they were out there or where they were. Cross country is a blast. There's nothing better than just you and your horse racing across the fields, jumping anything and everything in your path. But it's dangerous. And if you don't take that fact into account, and if you don't prepare for it, you'll end up in the hospital. You can not only hurt yourself, but you can hurt your horse. It's dangerous, and you have to be prepared. Today I've covered what cross country is, the difficulties of the sport, rider injury statistics, current safety precautions, and my own personal experiences. At this time, I would like to thank you all for coming out today and listening to my presentation. Here are my sources. Are there any questions?
I think my question would be just more personal for you. What level do you ride now?
So the question is, what level do I ride at? I currently ride at beginner novice level, which is just fine for my mom, but I have hopes to advance in the future. It's a lot of fun, but...
That's awesome.
Yes, I ride at beginner novice.
I really enjoyed this because this is something that I have some background in, but not a lot. And for a novice person who knew very little bit about this, you would get a lot out of your presentation. So I think it was very well done. Good job.
Thank you.
Good job.
I really enjoyed the part about your vests and the new technology that they've put into it, because that is a big thing in this right now, in this industry and going forward. And some of the people that maybe aren't quite as involved wouldn't know about some of the new technology that is coming in fire also. So that was really nice that you added that into it, and you seem to really enjoy giving it. It wasn't just read from a card.
Agreed.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Very nice.
Agreed. Thank you so much.